Like I don't do the regular kind
So
of
what
thing.
sound do you do?
It's still Afropop, but I think the way I write is just, that's what differentiates me from like every other person. Like I don't really talk straight. Like if I want to tell you to sit down, I won't probably say sit down. I will probably say take this. I don't know. I just, that's the way it comes to my, and I'm rich in my culture.
Okay.
Remember, like I lived with my grandma for like 17 years, so she has really helped my.
So with like proverbs and
like
just
all
things
those
like that.
Things like that. So I think I'll cope. I think I'll cope.
Is it important to you to sing in Yoruba? Like, was that something that you deliberately wanted to do?
Wanted
because
to do.
I mean, Yoruba or singing in indigenous languages has become very popular now. Or did you also have the battle of, oh, I'm going to alienate some people who don't understand this language? Wasn't that a problem for you as well?
Okay, yeah. When I was recording Eleko, I had that thing in mind. This thing you were saying, no, that what if an Igbo person is listening to this song, would this person be able to? So I tried
to. Outside Nigeria.
I tried to like fuse in a little bit English, but then I didn't want to drop that song first, because I felt I was going to sect myself in a particular group that is just Yoruba people that can understand it. But David just liked the song and he felt it was a breakout song. I have English songs. I'm not a Yoruba singer.
Yeah.
That was the reason why I didn't want to drop that song first, but. The management said this is the hit.
So were you surprised at the reception it got?
I was too surprised, because from the label, from the outside, I don't hear people do that kind of thing. They're always on the Fresh Boy P and all those things. And when they said they liked that song, are you sure you like this song? I have English songs, so like my next song, Double, is like 70% English. So they said, no, they like that one. It's very unique on it. So, I don't think so. I don't think I'm going to alienate some people, because I'll still drop. So I will drop Igbo songs.
How are you going to do that?
You get people to translate that.
So is commercial success more important for you? Because I mean, and it's not a bad thing. Don't think it's a bad thing. There are people who go into music and the sole purpose is to make money. Even if they like to sing, you need to make a lot of money from it. Is that because you also see from Davido, I mean, who is your label owner, that he's very flashy with you know the things he's acquired, you know, his cars, sometimes raw cash, you know, his clothing, he gets to flaunt it a lot on social media. So is that influencing you? Is it important for you that money has to be sort of the center of everything you're doing?
Like, do I think I should make money off?
Do you think that's the most important thing for you?
I think for me it's like one of the top things. It's not like the most important thing, but like if I should count first three, it should be there. Well, the most important thing for me is like to, because music for me is like pouring out my mind to people. I want people to be able to like see what I'm seeing from my own point of view. Then the money comes.
So what happens if, God forbid, in 4 years you've not blown as much as you want to have blown? Does that mean music is done for you?
No. Because while I was working in bank, I was still writing. Although working in bank wasn't what I wanted to do, but music was just part of me. So no, I will still do music.
Do you have a money target with DMW?
there's
an amount of money that you should have made for them, or
no, I don't have that. I don't. On my contract, there's nothing like that. No.
But there's pressure, of course, from the label to, you know, achieve certain things.
There's always pressure, because they have to make back.
Let's talk about Eleko now, and you know, there was a lot of controversy with especially the YouTube, the YouTube views. I mean, I think you hit 1 million views in 10 days.
In 10 days, yeah.
And Osage from Pulse TV,
Pulse
I think,
TV, yeah.
put out one of his talk shows, and categorically, now this wasn't him speculating. And Osage is someone who is quite respected, because he knows his onions. He was very categorical about the fact that you bought views to reach that number. And you know, it was a lot of controversy. I think you tried to respond, but that is there now. Tell us that story.
Okay, first off, I'm not a YouTube person. I don't know how YouTube works. I don't know. When David came to me and said, you made 77K in a day, I was like, okay, what is the big deal? Because me, I don't used to do this YouTube. So when it came out and someone was saying, when did you buy 1 million? I didn't buy views.
Is it possible the record label did without you knowing?
If the record label could have bought views for other people they've signed before, if that was what the whole thing was, David could have bought views for somebody else, and Well, I don't know. People like the song. That's why I feel. And at that point in time, David just signed his Sony deal. Now he's like open to newer fans in diaspora and all those things. There was one time I saw an interview of someone asking, a white person or someone over in UK or US was asking about me. That means we've gotten to that point. So we've had.
So there's a lot of views outside of Nigeria.
Outside of Nigeria. It's not like, to me personally, I don't think Nigerians do YouTube.
Okay.
We wish to wait until they show it on TV.
We need to save our data. We're going to take a quick break now. When we come back, we'll still be here talking with Mayokun. I almost said Mayokun there. With Mayokun to find out more about what he's doing and what he plans for the future. We'll take a break now and be right back.